Pretty girl swag. Coming. 3, 2, 1.
Ow!
This right here is my swag. All the boys all on me. Damn. Everybody pay attention.
Hey, what's up, guys? This is Dollface Trucker. I am back at you guys. This is my third day at night training. I'm tired as hell. So I'll just explain to you everything that we went through. So, no, it's not my third day. It's my second day. Sorry. So the first day we got there, you have to be there at 6 a.m. We got there, they passed out a packet with information. They talked about, I'm so tired I can't remember hardly. They talked about the rules, the yard rules. They talked about what we'll be training and how long we have, which is 2 weeks. And they gave us our badges. They paid for lunch for the first day. What they really, really, truly emphasize is the pre-trip inspection. They drill that into your head. It has to be done how they want it to be done. And it has to be done adequately and efficiently. You're going to test for your pre-trip inspection that Thursday after you arrive. You have to pass. You're allowed 90 points, and you're allowed to miss, I want to say, 21 points. If you don't pass, you get a second chance to do it again on Friday. And if you don't pass on Friday, they tell you don't come back on Monday. Basically, you're kicked out of the program. So everybody's tripping off of that. Then we go out into the yard and we practice our pre-trip. They show us a video about the pre-trip inspection, a couple of different videos. They show us where we can find other videos on YouTube and how to and look at those and practice. They give us an outline of how they want us to practice it. They go through it step by step. They thoroughly go through the pre-trip inspection. And then you go out into the yard and you do it. And that's all you're doing. You're just going through the pre-trip inspection all day long until 3:30, 4 o'clock. You get 2 breaks and you get an hour lunch. Then you come back into the classroom, answer any questions that you may have. And then they showed us a video about shifting, because that's going to be our next day, which is the second day, which was today. My instructor got sick and had to leave early, so we didn't do any shifting today. We just did some more pre-trip inspections, and that got drilled more and more and more and more and more into our head. They told us that we will automatically fail the pre-trip inspection if we do not ask the examiner to put on his seatbelt when he enters the cab for the in-cab inspection. And we automatically fail if we don't pass any one of the first 3 air brake tests, which is the air leakage test, the I should remember this right, air leakage test, the low air pressure warning test, and the emergency spring brake test. If we miss any one of those 3, we've automatically failed. However, you are allowed to take the test over and over again, or redo it as many times as you want. So say, for example, during your air leakage test, you found out you missed a step. Instead of, because how you end the test, they want us to say, that was a good test. That's the end of it, then we go to the next. Before we say that was a good test, if there's anything that you missed, you can say, I'm going to start the test over. And you have to start the entire in-cab inspection over again from the beginning. You can do that as many times as you want, as long as you don't say, that was a good test. So that's pretty cool, but you don't want to piss the examiner off and have him sitting on an in-cab for an hour. But they drill that into your head. Today we were supposed to start shifting and we didn't. So tomorrow we're gonna do that. They're gonna take us out to the speedway, and from what I'm told, we're going to practice on the shoulder first, and then if we get it down, then we'll go onto the actual speedway and practice. So they gave us some more videos to watch. One is a really good video. I'll put the link in the description. It's pretty cool. I like it. Or I'll put it in my playlist. And we're just preparing for our pre-trip evaluation. Once we pass that, the next step will be our backing and road skills testing and all that stuff. I heard we were not going to be tested on an alley dock. So we'll just be doing offset backing and straight backing and parallel parking. And then we get our CDL. We test, we get our CDL. We go back to our home terminal and test with Knight and go on the road with our trainer. So that's where I'm at now. I drove out here. I decided that it would be best so I can have freedom to move about as I want. I'm okay with that. And to prepare for this trip and for training, I just got a few things. I got work gloves and work shoes, a flashlight, a tire gauge, air pressure gauge, a tire thread depth gauge, I think that's what it's called, and bought some wipes, a blanket, a pillow. I was told that if you come to Squire training in Phoenix and you have nowhere to stay, absolutely nowhere, they will let you actually sleep in the yard in one of the tractors. I'm not sure how valid that is, but one of the guys in my training class, who was also in my orientation class in Las Vegas, did that. So he's doing that now. So that might be an option, because they don't pay for hotel or transportation. If you drive though, they will give you a reimbursement for your gas. So that's that. I need to find a vape shop. I'm almost out. It's almost gone. I need a vape shop, y'all. So what I'm going to do now, I guess, is go in and study some more of my pre-trip inspection. Make sure I have that down packed. What I'm struggling on is the fifth wheel. I'm struggling with the fifth wheel and the tandem. The parts. I'm struggling to remember the parts. I know more of the fifth wheel than I do the tandem parts. I'm still confused on that. But hopefully by Thursday I got it. And other than that, you guys, that's it. I will make a video the day after tomorrow. I'll probably be way too tired, because that clutching, I tried it. I started to practice a little bit. You guys, I stalled the truck so many times. I am terrible with manual. Like, I warned them. I'm like, I know how to drive. I know how to upshift. But I don't know how to downshift. Clutch. Rev, clutch. Brake? Like, I don't know. What if I hit somebody? What's going to slow me down? The brake or the clutch? And I heard if you stall, you automatically fail. That's what I'm afraid of. I'll go as slow as possible so I won't stall, or and I'm making sure I'm clutching correctly. But their clutching pattern is different. It's only 8 gears. It's not 10. And they give us this paper. I'll show you. And they're like RPM to gear ratio is different, because they want you to times it. One video I saw said that you have to add your mile per hour. So if you're at 35 miles per hour, 3 plus 5 is 8, so you're in 8th gear. But since we have 8 gears, they don't do it like this, like that. So they give us this, and these are our gear patterns. And Yep. I'm learning. They gave us a whole bunch of stuff. They also gave us a pre-trip knowledge quiz. And if you miss more than three, the rest of the crew goes out and starts their pre-trip inspection, and then they leave you behind if you missed any, and you got to go through it and hopefully you understand. Like, they're big on it. Like, if you don't do anything else before truck driving, especially if you want to drive at night, learn your pre-trip inspection front to back, top to bottom, in and out, period, because they don't play. So I'm gonna just, you know, wish for the best, hope for the best, pray for me. Hopefully I do well with my manual driving skills. And that's it, y'all. I'm so new to this YouTube thing. I don't know what to do, how to do it. I don't know what to talk about, who to talk about it with. I don't know. I want to go live, but I don't know what I would talk about. I don't want to just always talk about, like, Squire training and night driving school. I can show you something cool, though. So I graduated UNLV with a degree in the bachelor's degree in criminal justice, and I made my graduation cap. It has a tiara on it and all the little rhinestones. It's cute, right? I'm proud of this because I made this myself. The sun has it all wrinkled up, but I keep it in my dashboard because I'm so proud of it. It's so pretty. But I guess I'll see you guys later, and you guys wish me luck. Bye.